Hello everybody, welcome to Platform 32. My name's Ian Higton and this is part 3 of my Doom live stream series, although for some reason I've called the title Doom number 2. I'll change that now. As you may have noticed, my voice is a little bit croaky. I lost it over E3. I caught a dreaded E3 lurgy. I'm a little bit poorly, got some sneezes, got some blocked up noses. Well, I've got one blocked up nose. But I'm slowly starting to get a little bit better now. I can actually speak without it hurting. So I thought I'd get back onto the streaming wagon. It's been a long time since I've streamed. It feels like about 2 weeks. I think it was probably about 2 weeks. Maybe Thursday 2 weeks ago was the last stream I did. I've missed it, and I thought, well, it's time. It's time to get back into it. Let me load up the game, and then while it's loading up, I'll do some shout-outs, see who's watching. We're loading the campaign, and we're continuing on my ultra-violence playthrough. We've just got to hell, which will be exciting. So, who have we got? We got Jonabob, we got Wogsy Kirk, we got Irina, we got Steve Scodes, Plankton 1975, John D, Steamy Raven. Steve Scodes, I think, said, Irina's here. Hey, Irina. Hey, Steamy Raven. Hey, Plankton. Hey, Wogsy Kirk. He's been watching Deadpool. Hero Fanchuck as well. Hello, Hero Fanchuck. And March Rocks Nuts as well. Hello, March Rocks Nuts. Yes, welcome. So, stream-wise, I'm going to take it kind of easy with Doom. I thought, you know, with Doom, you can kind of turn your brain off a bit and just shoot and chat. So what I thought I'd do is just, if you guys want to know anything about E3, what I got up to, what it's like there, what we do for work when we're out there, what we eat when we're out there, any kind of questions like that, any kind of E3 questions you've ever been curious about E3 and what it's like, then let me know. I could talk you through it while I play through Cadingir Sanctum. Hello, Pair of Eight Silver as well, and Colby Ardito, and also Emma Harkham. This is the perfect time for a DayZ stream, says Jonabob87. It's true, I haven't downloaded the new patch though, Jonabob, actually. Might give that a go later on. John D reckons garlic soup and a hot whiskey will sort me out. I've tried everything except for that. Can I try whiskey soup and hot garlic instead? That might be alright. So, I don't know, you can't really tell, but I've got a tiny bit... Well, I did. I think the illness has actually made me look even pastier, but I did get a little bit of tan. And my hair, I don't know if you can tell, my hair's got, like, my hair gets bleached in the sun really easily. It's got kind of blonde bits at the front, which is nice. Did you have any fish tacos, says Steamy Raven? I did not have any fish tacos at E3, I'm afraid, Steamy Raven. Did you vom playing Fallout VR, says Irina? I didn't, but I found it kind of boring. I did a write-up for it about it on Eurogamer. And to be honest, I wasn't that impressed. You're just in the Red Rocket Station, the first place you meet Dogmeat, and you just walk around and you got a standard 10mm pistol, and all I did was take pot shots at some bottles and teleport around. Because you can't walk, you just look at a place and pull the left trigger and then you teleport there. Stops motion sickness, but you just kind of go boop, boop, and then you just like looking around, hey, Red Rocket, and that was it. And then they were like, right, demo's ended after about, like, I don't know, 180 seconds, about 2 minutes, maybe 120 seconds even. And I didn't even see any bad guys. I read a preview where one person who played said they fought against some bandits, but I didn't see any bandits. I don't know whether my playthrough was like ended before that, or whether I didn't trigger them or anything, but I didn't see any bandits running around that I could shoot at. It was literally just bottles and mannequins that I could shoot at. Wasn't very exciting at all, unfortunately. I was really keen though to play it. I ran really fast after the Bethesda conference to to get our hands on with the with Fallout VR. I got there first in the queue, and and then I was a little bit disappointed. So sad times. Steve Scones is excited for Watch Dogs 2. John Bob says it's 60 frames per second in cities. Zombies can't run through walls, but they can climb over certain obstacles, and there's lots of them now. All right, well, I will probably download DayZ after this and have a look. Have a look. All right, Surfer Boy Higgton, says John D. Must be talking about my blonde hair. Right, where are we? Sorry. If I don't answer a question, feel free to ask it again, because it looks like a whole load of questions have come in after I answered this question, and I don't want to have to keep standing still and looking at questions. So I'm going to go for the Did You Watch VR Porn After Bratters one from Alex Magoo. And yes, I did. I did have a go on VR porn. It was definitely an eye-opener, that's for sure. It was pretty extreme. I think the one thing that you can't really, that doesn't really come across on Chris's video is the sound. Like, you have these headphones on as well, and boom, got the Gauss cannon. Yeah, the sound is pretty brutal on the headphones. I'm not sure if it was 3D, true 3D sound or not, but there was a lot of sloppy, wet, slapping noises, which, I couple that with the fact that I knew there was like about 1,000 people stood around me, it made the experience very uncomfortable. It was kind of realistic. Everyone seemed kind of gigantic. They haven't really got the sense of scale right, I don't think, on it. But one thing I will say is that there's probably going to be a lot of lonely young people who buy a Gear VR or whatever, oops, I died, and never, ever, ever take it off. It's that realistic. I got an eyeful, that's for sure. She was massive. Honestly, it was like, it wasn't like massive as in like, you know, big boned. They looked like giants. Like, felt like I was tiny and there was these gigantic women bearing down on me, which isn't too bad. Monkey Truffle says sloppy wet slapping noises. Oh my god. I wasn't lying. It was pretty weird. That's a real British response to VR porn, Ian, says Andy Herbert. Yeah. There were some people there really digging it, like proper, like loving it, doing hand movements and things while they were trying it out, and people were filming them doing it and like laughing at them. I was just kind of sat there going, oh my word, I actually, what the fuck, I fell through the scenery there. What were the QA testers for that bit? Chris looked really uncomfortable, said Steve Scodes. He was, he felt really uncomfortable as well. It was quite funny filming him. I was behind the camera lolling. Sounds like my worst nightmare, Higgton, says John D. Well, John D, there was also, like, so the way you see it, right, you put the VR headset on, and you're not stood up. Like, it takes a second, and you're like, oh, I'm laid down, and you're actually, you're kind of looking down your body, and the guy you're looking at, it's just, there's just a big erect penis right in front of you. So there's stuff for all tastes. I'm sure they do. They weren't showing off any gay porn. It was all pretty much heterosexual fantasies, because there was some girl on girl stuff. But I'm pretty sure that it won't take long for them to be doing gay porn on the VRs as well. Right. It's been a while since I played Doom. I've forgotten all the buttons. And I'm playing on ultra violent. So I've got to be careful. Oh god. I need some help, man. Actually, on the plane over, I took my PlayStation Vita and I got re-addicted to The Binding of Isaac. I played The Binding of Isaac for about 4 hours straight until my Vita battery ran out on the plane. Love that game again. I used to love it before, and then I got kind of bored of it, and then my addiction set in again. True, John D says he can do that without VR. That's very true, John D. Very true indeed. Time for me to start saving for a Vive, says Wogsy Kirk. VR porn sounds awesome. You don't need to save for a Vive, Wogsy Kirk. It works with Google Cardboard and Samsung Galaxy One, what's it called? The Gear VR, which is about 100 quid, so you don't need to spend £800 on it if you don't want to. Works well. It is definitely the next level in porn, and I can imagine it being pretty big, if you pardon the expression. Possibly not something you want to show your parents, so. Not looking for questions because shooting. Shit! Oh no. Batted. Will there be a VR stream in the future, Ian, says Slick. Good question. As soon as I get my PlayStation, my PSVR, there will be. That'll be the easiest way for me to do VR streams, I think. Ian, what are the sleeping arrangements like at E3? Are you sleeping in one room like a grotty student flat? Good question, Irina. We did actually have a very nice Airbnb booked, but about a week before E3 it cancelled, so we had to go for a last-minute Airbnb. Oh, fuck's sake, the checkpoints on this are a bit of a dick. the Airbnb we had instead was not great at all. I ended up having to sleep on a blow-up airbed, a blow-up mattress in the middle of the living room. Chris and Tom Phillips shared a room, and Wes and John Linneman from Digital Foundry shared the other room because those guys are super snorers. I went on the blow-up bed because of my insomnia. I didn't want to disturb other people. Turns out it's even harder to get to sleep on a blow-up bed if you have insomnia than on a normal bed. So I didn't really get very much sleep at all. In fact, I probably got, for the whole week, I probably got about 12 hours. Pretty brutal. I slept for 12 and a half hours straight when I got home, though. My body finally was like, holy shit, you definitely need some sleep after this. I'll stop torturing you, boy. Get some sleeps. Hey, Stevie Mac. Ian, are we sorting you out with a copy of Battlezone VR, says Mark Rocks Nuts? I sure hope so, Mark. I played it again at E3. I did better. Like, it was the same demo I played when I came to visit your studio. Bash! But this time I knew what to expect, so I did a lot better. I'd love to get a copy and stream some of that. As far as I know, it's going to be launching around the same time PSVR launches, so yeah. All over some VR, all over some Battlezone streams. Were you jet-lagged, says Steve Skies? Yes, I was jet-lagged when I got there, and I wasn't too bad when I got back for jet-lag, because I waited until like about 9 o'clock UK time to go to sleep when I got back. It meant that I'd been awake for 36 hours. But then I slept for 12 hours and woke up about 8 a.m. or 9 a.m. the next day. And my body clock was then kind of like in sync. So I didn't get too much jet lag. I think if I'd have... gone to bed really early or slept on the train, I probably felt a lot worse than I did. I was alright, but yeah, I did get a bit of jet lag when I was there. I just spent, the whole thing feels like a crazy dream because I was so tired when I was there. And it's so busy and everything's so crazy and weird. Like, time goes really fast because there's just so much stuff to see and do. So yeah, it just felt like I was in the middle of a crazy dream. Looking back now, like, did it really happen? Was I really there? It was really happening. Video to prove it. But it still felt a little bit bizarre. Eat your heart, sucker. Who's next? Getting the skills part, I shouldn't have said that because that's probably going to get me killed. Where's he gone? Did you play Gears 4, says John Bob? I did not. No hands on time with Gears of War 4, unfortunately. I think Wes got to play it, Wes from Eurogamer, but not I. The only time I've ever played it is the beta that was released. Days Gone By looks just like a Last of Us clone. I got really excited when Days Gone By started up because I thought it was The Last of Us 2. I was like, oh my god, Last of Us 2! And then was kind of disappointed that it wasn't. But it does, definitely. It's made by a different company though. So they've really just... God of War 4 looks a bit like a Last of Us clone as well. I think everyone's seen how... you know, people in video games, movies, music, they... SHIT! They copy one another. Bollocks. I hope it doesn't send me all the way back. It's probably like that, isn't it, with video games? I saw how well The Last of Us did, and now everyone's like, oh, we gotta do something the same! What games did you get to play, says Steve Scodes? Titanfall 2, Battlefield 1, Sniper Elite 4, Battlezone. Not very many games, to be honest. Shadow Warrior 2, Serious Sam VR, The Climb VR, Absolver, Strafe. A little bit of Zelda. Very, very little, though. Most of the time I was running around filming or editing, to be fair. Oh, fuck, wow. This is going to be an interesting stream of me just doing the same bit over and over again. I'll do this time. Knock them down. Keep asking them questions, though. I'll tell you what we had to eat. I think I put on about 6 pounds... when I was in America because of the American food. First morning, like, we got into LA really late, like 9 o'clock, so we didn't really eat anything. I only had a couple of snacks. So we pretty much just have a beer, go to sleep. Oh god. First morning, we went for an IHOP. And I had a steak. I had a steak and cheese omelette with a side of pancakes and syrup, which made me feel sick for 2 days. We went out for a Mexican meal, which was fantastic. Like big burritos, like just infinite tortilla chips on the table. You don't get it in the UK. You go to a restaurant, they'll bring out a bread or something. And if you want some more, you have to pay for it. But in this Mexican restaurant, it was just like every time the guy saw that our bowl of tortillas had gone, they'd come and replenish it and put new dips out and everything. All for free, it was amazing. What else did I eat? We went to a Japanese restaurant. I had this amazing Wagyu steak. I went to a place that I've been to every time I've been to E3. It's located quite close to the Staples Center. It's a place called the Original Pantry Cafe. And I had a Philly cheese steak sandwich with the restaurant's famous homemade coleslaw and fries, and but super fatty. And then I had loads of sweets as well. Lots of peanut butter, chocolatey type things. I was in heaven with that. It was super good. Oh my god, I died again, for fuck's sake. I love it when they keep giving you more food, says Steve Scodes. Me too, Steve Scodes, me too. Chicken and waffles are pretty good, says Mike Tiger. I only ever had chicken and waffles once, and that was with, that was in 2012 E3, when I went there. I went to a chicken and waffle place with my friend Richard and the guy who was doing cameras for me out there, Julian. That was very good. I am doing super awful at the moment. I don't know whether it's because I'm talking, not really paying attention, or because I'm ill. I'm going to put it down to the fact that it's not because I'm rubbish. Some other excuse. So apologies that you're seeing this the same bit over and over again. Hopefully my chitter-chatter and my my stories are keeping you interested. Man, I love peanut butter chocolate sweets. Me too. I had many Reese's Pieces, a big bag of peanut butter M&Ms. Even though you can actually buy peanut butter M&Ms in the UK pretty easily, I still picked up some peanut butter M&Ms from America. Ian, can you sneak me into E3 next year, says John above. Well, you are pretty wee, so I could probably fit you in my suitcase, to be honest. Hello, Steve. What's this guy doing? Boom. There he goes. So he's doing a little dance for me. Steve Mack says he doesn't think Microsoft did themselves any favours. Sony was definitely the best of the show in my books. They just... Microsoft's, like, conferences, they still kind of feel very corporate. Whereas Sony have managed to get really good at being a lot more theatrical about their announcements. It's just like games, shock, announcement, games. Like they do, someone was saying, I can't remember, I read it somewhere or heard it somewhere, but someone was saying, like with Microsoft, they'll go, coming up for you now, it's the next installment of Gears of War. We're going to be showing you how we're making it even better and more wonderful. And then they show you a gameplay demo and you're like, oh, okay, fair enough. Whereas Sony, they die. They like go, they just don't say anything. They stick on this video and you're like, what the hell is this? What's going on? Holy shit, it's Gears of War 4 and Kratos has got a beard in the sun. Wow. And everyone like talks about it. And I think that's the difference really, like, PlayStation that have, you know, this kind of like theatrical element that Microsoft just haven't been able to capture. Charge. I reckon next year they're slowly taking leaves out of Sony's book in the way they do things. So I reckon next year their E3 conference might be a little bit more like, well, less kind of official looking. Ow! More like an entertainment thing. Sorry. Trying to think of words while also trying to dodge projectiles. a little bit tricky at times. Stop throwing shit at me! I love jumping at bad guys. And then doing the takedowns. Ooh, missed him. That sounded like something. I'll look down at my comments, my questions again in a minute. Just need to work out what the hell I haven't killed yet. Something around. Oh, there he is. Someone else gonna spawn? Someone's there. Oh god, it's this. The Hell Knight. Oh fuck. Two Hell Knights. Eat my fist, you little shit. Did I do it? Yes. I done it. Alright, phew, there we go. We can carry on. Death Stranding is basically PT, but as a game, says iArena. Well, I don't know. I think it's going to be pretty different to PT. You never know. It might not be. But it sounds like Hideo Kojima is going for something completely different. I mean, we're not even sure if there's going to be any combat in the game or anything yet. All we know is that Norman Reedus was holding a Norman fetus, and even that potentially might be different, because he said in an interview that it took them 2 months to make that, like, that teaser, and the rest of the game only really exists on notepads and in his brain. They haven't even decided on what engine to make the game on yet. Turn down the game sound, Ian, says Stevie Mac. Alrighty. That might have done it. Is my mic quite quiet? What is it on? Normal level. Okay, cool. I think I'm up to date with any questions. How was the new Resident Evil, Ian? Have you played the VR version, says Slick? I haven't. I played the demo, and it was alright. You could definitely see they'd taken a lot of influences from PT. But, I don't know. I'm going to be interested to see how it ties in with the rest of the series, because it's just so different. Allegedly, the voice on the telephone is, well, people are speculating that the voice on the telephone is Ada Wong. Whether or not that's true, it's another thing. I like first-person horror games. Resident Evil is well known for playing silly buggers with its formula, so hey, might as well try something different. Ooh, we got a rune trial to do. Maybe. Oh no, we haven't.
Stage in the first battle when the shadows first lengthened.
Yeah, I'm happy now, I has been updated. There's been a few secrets and stuff that I've missed so far. Actually, there's loads of secrets and things on this level that I'm yet to get.
Um,
But I think I just need to concentrate on surviving more than actually looking for secrets at the moment. That's that new Fallout DLC this week. Not too interested in it, to be honest. I haven't done any base building for ages. I leave that stuff to the people who are actually good at it. I can do the basics, but then I see some of the crazy builds that people have done, and I'm like, I don't know what I'm fucking rich. Oh shit. Oh shit. Oh shit. Oh shit. This is not good. Alright. Might get me some health. No, it won't give me coming. Don't! Hey, Dougie! Hey, Stray, how's it going? Did you get to meet any famous developers, Ian, says Andy Herbert. Ooh, famous developers, did I? I walked past Tim Schafer. I walked past Ashley Johnson, the voice of Ellie from The Last of Us. I met Julian Gollop, who was the original creator of XCOM. I met played a game next to one of Hugh Hefner's ex-wives. He wasn't a famous developer, he was famous. Kendra Wilkinson. Playing Ghost Recon Wildlands. She was sat next to me. Well, opposite. Need to deal with this witch. Oh god. This bit's gonna be hard. Did you make Ashley Johnson do her Ellie voice, Destroyer? Her voice, her normal voice, is kind of an Ellie voice, to be honest. How's your game of VR porn, Ian, says Dougie. I've already answered that one, Dougie, about 10 minutes into the stream. I won't talk about it again. People think I'm obsessed. Did you feel up Nolan North's bum again? No, I didn't, John D, I'm afraid. You look exhausted, Ian, says Emma Harkham. I'm poorly. I got the expo flu, so I'm not exactly full of beans, unfortunately. I played a video game next to Hugh Hefner's ex-wife. That's pure Partridge, says Andy Herbert. Yeah, I'll do my best, you know. Tried to give her a bit of New Yorkie. Wasn't the toga ring, I can't remember. I think it was toga ring. Bang. Let's concentrate on some demon slaying. Oh, shot his legs off. All I need to do is kill the witch before any of the big ones appear. Come, witchy. Are you? Damn it, big one's appeared. You're dead. dead yet, and these things are still coming. The reason I need to kill the witch first is because she can res baddies or spawn them in. Oh, I've got no ammo. Oh, shit. Oh, dear. Hey, Jumbo Jumbo. Pretty much all of the mods I've downloaded for Fallout so far have been for settlement buildings as iArena. I bet your settlements are better than mine. Oh, wait. Jumbo Jumbo. What was the map? What's the code for the map you made? The Platform 32 map? I should play this. Ian, interested in a Sea of Thieves community series, says Drunk Doggy. Definitely. Definitely. I've met some of the developers of Sea of Thieves as well. I got a hug off one of them, Mike Chapman, because I awarded them the Eurogamer Editor's Choice. I tried to run around and give the Editor's Choice badge out to people. That was quite good. Good fun. Going to all the stands going, hey, got an award for you guys, Editor's Choice. First time we've ever done like awards at an expo. So they were quite prestigious awards. I was like, you're the first people to have ever won these, you know. You! Oh, there's another one! Oh, yeah. Oh, no, oh, no! Oh, no, 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 oh, no. Might as well try out Jumbo's Doom map. Oh, fuck. Wow, this is getting hard. During this stream. Seeing as I'm not playing too well today. Do do do. Matt Rotts Nuts is back. Hello, sir. I need to get the power up that makes enemies drop armor. The rune that makes enemies drop armor when you do the thingy. When you do the Killotron. Corporal Killington, at your service. Oh, yes. Right. That's one way to do it. Rocket to the legs. Oops, wrong button. Let's get back to the shotgun. The code for my level. Right, 2 secs. The code for my level is that, and the level's called Saving Kent's Soul. Alright, well, I'll play your level on this stream in about 45 minutes or so, depending on how badly I do. Or how well I do. Shit, better get my Doom map published, says, says Drunk Dougie. Oh, wow. That is a bad photo. Oh no, there we go, I got it. There's an extremely boring video on my channel with some of the supplements I built on my first day of playing around with the mods, though everything looks much cooler now I've spent time with it, says Aya. I see. What's going on here? to it. Right. Hey, Rena, what? Okay, right. Let's get back to it. Right, already pressing the wrong buttons. Oh, fuck. Not good. Not good. Not good. Any trouble? Fuck. Three hell knights. Jesus piss. John D's talking about being in Uncharted. He's also in Zombie U. Zombie U, you make my world come true, or something. Okay. So, didn't do too good there. This time I put my headphones on properly. I don't know why wearing headphones properly will enable me to play better, but this is the I'm just trying anything now. Snapped its weird head off. He's flash damage. You're next. Flash. Flash. This. Oh fuck. Oh fuck. Oh fuck. Oh fuck. Oh fuck. Wow. Holy shit. Hey, Mr. Tom. He's got fiber broadband this past week. He's thinking about starting to stream stuff himself. Well, take it from me. It's very good fun, but very addictive. Why are people... No! Stop doing hashtag RIP Kent. I can't believe you'd make me feel guilty all over again. I am doing terrible. This is hard though, this is not easy. I'm doing it on the hardest difficulty setting that's not like one of the ridiculous ones. Oh, I got to the brink with that sneeze and it's going. Oh, annoying. Look at the light and see if I can. It's gone. Annoying! Now I've got a light shape in front of my eyeballs. Excellent. Where are you? Where is it? Oh, there was the other one. Oh, shit, 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 shitty, shit. Shitty. Shitty, shitty, shit, shit. Shitty, shitty, shit, shit. Fuck. Oh, fuck. Oh, shit. You're mine. Oh, God, fuck. Running back, because in Doom's not a good idea. Help! Ah, killed myself with the splash damage. Hashtag RIP Kent t-shirts, make it happen. I could do. Gotta sell some of them on Teespring. You'll never guess what I did. I forgot to mention this. Not happy with myself at all. So I bought myself one of the iArena design Platform 32 t-shirts. Wasn't going to wear it. I thought wearing a t-shirt with my own face on would be a little bit weird. I just wanted it as a souvenir. Never going to get it. I got it delivered. Got it delivered to my old house. I'll never see it again. There's a slight chance that whoever's moved into my own house won't take the parcel and open it up and keep it for themselves. But from the neighbourhood I moved out from, that's not going to happen. That t-shirt is lost. So, yeah, sad times. Just spent all that money for someone else to have a t-shirt with my face on it. Didn't I feel like a Wally when I realised? The answer is yes, I did feel like a Wally. I never got the chance to order one. Hey, I got a subscriber though. We got one subscriber. Maybe the person that subscribed is the person that got the new t-shirt. There's a person in Redditch lounging beside a black fireplace, snuggling in a cozy Irina shirt with a warm mug of Stella, says John D. Probably. As long as they don't burn it in the fireplace. So yeah, that was disappointing. But hey ho, you win some, you lose some. I've changed my address on that site now. I did email them to see if they could help, but they were like, order's been processed now, mate. Get fucked. So, oh, thanks. Thanks for your excellent customer service. Not. I'm stuck on the floor. Is it gone? Stop warping. Run! This is probably going to be bad. Just going to jump backwards off a ledge. No, I'm not! I'm stuck on a wall! Fuck! Ow! No! Why can't I kill him?! Deal with the small fries. Get a bit of health back. Try and deal with these fuck sandwiches. Ah, piss. What? I got an email saying my order had been cancelled, says Aya. What? Must be the same person Ian sends his shirts to hogging on the shirts. Oh, that sucks. Do do do. Do do do. Huh. My t-shirt is due between Friday and next Tuesday, says Drunk Dougie. Well, at least one person will get a t-shirt. I wonder if, do you reckon Deanna's got cancelled as well? Do do no. Yeah, to be honest, you should probably make your own. It'll end up being cheaper for you, I think. And your order won't get cancelled. I wonder why your order got cancelled then. The other ones got delivered to Australia. If they cancelled Deanna's, then perhaps they've just stopped posting to Australia. If they haven't cancelled the Annas, then God knows. Either way, not impressed with my idiocy. I should be used to it by now, to be honest. Fuck! Being an idiot's part of my DNA. My hoodie was being printed 12 days ago, hasn't been dispatched yet, says Plankton. Ooh, Plankton got the hoodie, nice. Oh fuck. Damn it. Super dying. What's this? Halloween. Is this the same company who did the retro rum shirts as John D? Yeah, it is, yeah. Great but expensive marketing ploy. Send random people your face on a t-shirt, says Emma Harkin. Well, we'll see if it works. I've got one subscriber today. Perhaps that's the t-shirt person. Ian, are booth babes a thing of the past now at E3? There seems to be a lack of articles on them these days. There weren't any booth babes? Same thing, I guess. There weren't any booth babes at this year's E3. Looks like the games industry is finally growing up a bit. Maybe. Don't know whether they've been banned or not. They've been banned at Eurogamer Expo for a long time now. Because Eurogamer is like a consumer show. We get everyone coming, mums, dads, girls, boys. We don't want little girls to go to a game show and all they see half-naked ladies swanning around. They want to meet female developers and chat to female gamers and people who are like them, not some kind of weird, phony fake view of women that people in marketing seem to like. And there's always been booth babes at E3. This is the first year that I've seen them not be any. So I presume hopefully things are growing up a bit. Mike Tiger's flying home. He's flying back to America's, I think. Safe travels, Mike. Looks like the games industry is finally growing up. Blasts demon in the face to incinerate it, then rocket packs over some lasers. Yeah, looks like it's as Mark writes nuts. Fair enough. I can wear some skimpy pants if people are prepared to pay me a reasonable sum, says Andy Herbert. Yeah, me too. Me too. I think people would probably pay me not to wear skimpy pants, though. I demand male booth babes, says John D. Well, I think if there's going to be booth babes, there should be male booth babes as well. But that's the thing, isn't it? That's why booth babes makes games industry less inclusive, because there aren't male booth babes. So that kind of thing doesn't appeal to the women's, to the, you know, that thing, kind of thing, isn't there to appeal to the women's, or the men folks who like the men's. So it just paints games as a straight male place, which, you know, is not the case. As I've learned, especially with Platform 32 community, which is lucky enough to be made up of people of all tastes, colours and religions and everything. It's a very cool mixed group here. Boink, boink, boink. Right. This fucking... these shitbags are going down. Fuck you! I'm running away from you! Stop chasing me! Get the hint! I don't want to fight you! I want to be fun! New friends! Okay. Where's that? Oh no, I've nommed that health pack. There's some health. Nom. Nom nom. Oh shit. Oh god. I have the solution. Everyone at Games Expo should be nude. John D, you have obviously never been to a Games Expo. People who go to Games Expos shouldn't be nude. Gets a bit smelly. Ian, don't forget about your bloody chainsaw, says Stevie Ray. Steve, I did forget about my chainsaw. What time is it? Right, we're an hour in. I totally forgot about my chainsaw. I put it down to being poorly and not having played the game for ages. That could be just the thing I need, though. One's down. You're down. Oh, wasted it. I want to use it on a big one.
Damn it, fuck you!
Yeah! Ah, well, that was so much easier. There was only one Hell Knight that time. I guess... the witches didn't spawn two more of them. Ian, download the DayZ patch while you stream. I don't want to kill my bandwidth, John and Bob. No. Where are we going? We got any secrets around here? I don't like it. The music in this is well good. I do like it, John and Bob. It is well bow, I tell thee. Nothing up here? Nothing up here. Creepy stones. That's not creepy. There's a door up here at the start. Is this the way to the start? Maybe not. How do I get up to that? Oh, there's the door. How do I get to that armor? Is it just an easy... Yeah, it's just a simple hop, step and a jump. Yeah. One of John Dee's dogs just kissed his cheek, then burped in his face. At least I think it was one of his dogs. Alright, lovely. Le door has let open. Wonderful. Wonderful. Ow! Alright, so health. Got this, and there's a little secret up round here I remember from last time I played. Here we go. And through the teleporte. Teleporte, motherfucker. Here we got that. We pick up the, come on, blue thing. Ian, did you see the look of quiet desperation in the eyes of the Nintendo representative, says Andy Herbert? Actually, I expected them to look a little bit quiet and desperate, but Zelda's so fantastic, and it's been getting so much good press that they're all pretty like, yep, it's taken us ages, but look what the fuck we've made. They're pretty excited about it, to be honest. And so am I, after seeing it in action. I keep nearly sneezing, but then it keeps going away again. How do I get to that bit? More bads. Keiko demons! Ah, oh, they fly. Ah, oh, he bit my head off. Did you play Zelda, Ian, says Jonabob? Like, literally 10 minutes, if that. Like, not enough to even, like, work out the controls. Tom Phillips played it 4 times in the end, and he got to play it loads. He got to try out all the different areas, and, well, say all the different areas. He got to explore loads of different areas. Didn't see anything of what the full beginning section had to offer, though, he reckons. He said there was so much there, and there's, like, no real signpost somewhere to go. It just, like, lets you go. It's just like, here you go, here's a world. Win it. And you just go off and explore and see what's what. I'm gonna bake you a Keiko demon. Ah, blind. Ow. Pop. Oh. What have we got here? Quad damage. Thanks. Quad damage is much more useful. Bam! Well, oh, just ran out just as the Baron of Hell turned up. What's in that? I can't do it yet. Oh no, out of ammo. Ah! Yup, boing. Right, I'm back now that I've troll tweeted Ian. Holy shit, what have you done? Don't like the sound of that. Fuck! Oh! Why would you do that, Aya? Everyone's talking about dogs now. Seems like the most popular dog in the comments is a black lab. Although Stroyer has a Welsh Springer Spaniel. I used to have a golden Labrador. But he died many years ago now. Probably. About... about 15 years ago. Never had a dog since. Too much like hard work, I think. Come here, boy! Ow. Shit. Explode him on! Whoa! Oh, a fucking this! Goody, goody! Another one gone. Careful what I wish for. What? What? Run! I do have Colin. You're right, Steamy Raven. Colin is the best dog to have. You are correct, of course. Lots of deaths this stream. Surprised Lizzie's not here keeping count. Right, come on. I get through it in the end, it just takes me a while. I'd like to blame it on being ill, but I'd probably play just as bad if I was healthy, to be honest. Okay, let's just get a lay of the land. The health there. Is there a... okay. Right. Oh, fuck. Goodbye. Oh, shit. Okay, in trouble. Let's get this. And then let's go whip. Oh fuck, missed it. Trouble. Ah! Ah, stop it! The bounce, the... oh fuck. Oh shit. Let me get my
quad damage, you fuckers.
Nice. I forgot about my chainsaw again. There's an amazing jump chainsaw there. Mancubus. Oh no, 3% health. Oh shit. There's too many bad guys, and I've got 6 health. Oh fuck. Oh no. That's not. Fucking pick the right one. Have I found a cheat spot? Holy shit. That was intense. Hey, Deanna. Deanna, has your iArena design t-shirt been cancelled? Has your order been cancelled? Because Aya's did. We're just wondering if everyone in Australia has been cancelled. Or whether just they're picking on iArena. Fuck! That was stupid. Boblong! Finally. Made it. Argent cell. I need to go ammo. I picked this up today secondhand for £15. Ideal when not on internet, so still life. £15 for this game is well good. It's proper bow, I tell thee. No, it's real good. It's well worth 15 scridge. Hey, secret found. Rune trial time. I don't think so, Ian. How do I check? Didn't get an email, says Deanna. If you didn't get an email, then I think you'll be fine. Aya got an email saying hers had been cancelled. So you might be alright. God knows why Aya's has been cancelled then. Everyone in the UK's should be getting theirs posted. I got mine delivered to my old house. So it's lost forever. Whoops. Kill imps with the super shotgun to allow movement for 4 seconds. Imps may be killed or spared at your discretion. Reach the altar before the timer expires. Well, I don't think I've don't think I've... Oh, fuck. I don't think I've, done this one before. It's the one I missed. Uh-oh. Oh, fuck. Oh, fuck. Oh, God. This is a little bit tricky. Ah, come on. All right, let's try it this way. Words are very hard for me today. I'm poorly. Normally words are hard for me anyway, but they're even harder when I've got the sniffles. Pouring in with the sniffles. Oh fuck. Oh fuck, reload! Oh, you cock whistle. Words are hard for Eon. He doesn't know what they mean. The time has to Google them. Oh no, fuck. Fucked it. Oh, run out of puff in midair. Need a quick reload gun, says Deanna. I do, but this challenge, I can only use the super shotgun. So I'm screwed. I reckon I'll do it this time, mate. Fuck, maybe not. What? Yeah. Did it. I'll sort it or print my own t-shirts as Irina. Yeah. All right, shall we try out the level that Jumbo Jimbo made, the platform 32 level. Because this is obviously going to be a checkpoint. Bum 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 bum. Got like 40 minutes left on the stream. I'm starting to feel a bit fatigued now. I'm so ill and weak. My voice is a bit better than it was yesterday when I recorded the voiceover for my Gears of War video that I put up today. Alright, so... should be a checkpoint anyway. I didn't see the checkpoint thing pop up, so I'm worried now. Thank you. Where are we going? Ah! That way. This way. This way. Yep. Ghosties. This bit took me ages playing when I played on the level just below this, so God knows how long it's going to take me to do this bit now. Maybe because I've played through it loads, I'll know how to do it. Chances are not. I was trying to get whatever that is. My level will take 5 or 10 minutes to do, but it's full of jokey goodness with fun references and jibes and stuff. Says Jumbo Jimbo. Okay, I'll wait for a sec then. I'll have another couple of runs at this. What's this? Hey, 86. Has he played your level, 86? To Dougie. Dougie's needs to publish it. Oh, maybe I can play Dougie's as well. Let me know what the code is when you've done it, Dougie. Oh yeah, annoying. Do this whole big bloody fuck run up. Oh, yep. You big bum. You big pooey pooer. Look, ghosts. Get ready, ghosts. Might as well be. Alright. Come at me. Come at me, Zombros. Boop. Oh no. Oh no. Hey. No. Oh no, what is this? It is low, what? Invulnerability? Perfect. Just what I needed. Oh, invulnerability's run out, that's not good. Okay, a bit of an Easter egg coming up. For all you id Software fans, it's Commander Keen's helmet, emblazoned with the Doom logo. Commander Keen was one of the first id Software games, side-scrolling shooter. Looks like Mario with guns almost. Now we've got a chainsaw. Ooh, oh, a chainsaw? A chain gun. We also have a chainsaw. This is the chain gun. Oh, Chainsaw, do it for Kent's a steamy rave on. Maybe. We got some things to kill with the... Some lost souls to take out. Who's next? Who's next to join the Punch Club? Spinium. Doom. Armor. Doom. Doom. Any secrets hidden around? Not there. There's a thingy there. Doom. 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 Please don't fall. Good. Go, I did that a lot easier than I did it the first time I played. Crazily. Open the door, this crazy skull door, and just have a quick look. Seem to have got all the secrets from this bit. There's some above me in a room up there somewhere. I don't know how you get them though. Oh. Well. Thanks for the rest, Doom. See, I've got tired now. Most of my commentary now has turned into like, I'll get you, and write and swear words. Damn it. Half past. Alright. Let's just see where the checkpoint was. Sniff. Alright. So that's where the checkpoint is. Okay. Let's exit the main menu and let's have a go with the Platform 32 level built by Jumbo Jumbo. Snap map. Accept. Gotta work out how to download them now. I think if there's time, if he gets it done in time, we'll try Dougie's as well. Don't know if his is finished or not yet. He says he needs to upload it, so it might not be finished. Fishnished. Takes a long time to load this old snap map. Got any more questions about E3 you want me to answer? Now's the time. P32 level for the win, says Emma Harkham. And Jumbo Jumbo says, yay, he's going to play my level. I will do, when this thing finally loads. 93, 94. Come on, stuck on 94. Ooh, come on, come on, come on, come on, come on. Come on, 94. Come on, come on, you can do it. Come on, stuck on 94. Oh, there we go. What was the worst, most disappointing game you played at E3, Ian, says John D. I'm going to say Outlast 2. Not because it was rubbish, because it was good, but because I had an interview and a hands-on session lined up for it. I was expecting it to be awesome, thought I could capture, and I was going to film myself playing it with a scare cam and stuff. And turned out it wasn't in a little booth on its own. It was out on the show floor and amongst millions of people. There was no interview, and the demo was the same demo that they showed at PAX that I'd read all about anyway, so no, there was nothing like really to make me jump because I knew what to expect. So yeah, rather disappointing. So it wasn't bad, but I was very disappointed with my hands-ons with it, because it meant I couldn't make a video out of it, and I was just hoping that I could have had a cool, scary, like, let's play thing, but nuh-uh. So sad times. Right, so I need to search by GZQ77 6KM. Saving Kent's Soul by Jumbo Jimbo. Ian the Butcher Higton is responsible for many deaths in the wastelands, most notably Kent. May Kent rest in peace. Alright, here we go. Let's save it to my downloaded maps. And then play? Accept. Play. Alright, here we go. Save the Last Guardian and watch Shitstorm happen, says Matt. I didn't get to play The Last Guardian, unfortunately. Alright, connecting. Here we go, ready. Start game. Sorry, got a runny nose. Apologies if I sniff. I didn't bring a tissue. Je suis Kent, says Irina. Hashtag Je suis Kent. Hashtag RIP Kent, says Steamy Raven. It's ridiculous. The Last Guardian is never coming out, says John and Bob. It was playable at E3. It's almost 100% coming out. Maybe. 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 Wes played it. I didn't get to. You're only allowed one appointment per outlet. So, I couldn't be like, oh, I want to play Last Guardian as well. Doesn't work like that. So, everything that, like, you know, all the games Chris played were different to all the games I played, were different to all the games Wes played, and were different to all the games Tom played. Which is kind of sad. Did you play the new God of War, Ian, says Steamy Raven? I didn't. I don't think that was playable at E3. I think it was just the game demo, Steamy Raven. It may have been playable, but I didn't know if it was. Alright. Kent has been murdered by the evil demon known as Ian the Butcher Hyten. Spelt my name wrong. Higton. Alright, so we started off. Let's come up here, get a look around. Okay. Pretty quiet. Flighty words. Good door action. You must vanquish the butcher, but first you must defeat his minions. How many E3s have you visited, says John D. I've visited 3. And I have not tried We Happy Few. Okay, here we go. It's pretty quiet at the moment. I think I've... Oh no, it's Jonabob! Destroy him! So Jonabob is the pinky demon, I guess. To be honest, killing Jonabob in video games is pretty easy. He's a strong man. There we go. Tore Jonabob's tooth out. Stabbed him in the eyeball with it. Got damage indicators on this. More bad guys spawning. Boom. Oh shit! Where'd you come from, sucker? Woo. Wow, there's a lot of Zeds, a lot of Zombs. See, these guys are more of a challenge than Jonabob was. Running out of ammo though. Oh fuck! Oh fuck! Have I got any other? Oh no. I don't seem to have any more ammo. Right. Okay, there's no ammo pickups. I may have to, good job on taking out Jonabob with +3 health left. No ammo. There we go, got some ammo. Where now? That's awfully tall for Jonabob, says John D. But there are still many more of Ian the Butcher Higton's minions. Oh, he got my name right that time. Welcome to the hellish dungeon of Drunk Dougie. Okay. We need some ammo if we're about to... I'm going to finish off... If we're going to finish off Drunk Dougie. Oh, wait. My map is UYDVSQ. Take a photo of that. And then I'll play Dougie's one after. Okay. The zombies aren't important, just the bigger demons. Okay. I have a feeling I might die, so... that's the case, I can restart and just run past the zombies to conserve my energy. Where am I? What have I done wrong? Nice ramp. Have I done something to stop the enemies from spawning? I guess I can't go down here, or can I? And say no. My birthday soon, gosh darn it. This is Jonah Bob. Well, happy birthday, I killed you. I think maybe I've glitched it. Unless I do have to go down here. Oh, no. A dip in disodium 37. Righto. Okay, right, let's... What? I missed it. Okay. I missed a message. Good job on taking out Jonabob. He was a massive self-pleasurer. There's still many more of Ian the Butcher Higton's minions. Welcome to the hellish dungeon of Drunk Dougie. Did I screw up making my levels, says Jumbo Jimbo? Maybe. Mark Rock's Nuts says, your level needs a patch. Welcome to the industry. It looks like possibly you might have done, sir. There does not seem to be any Dougies here. Can I go this way? Secret? No. I think it might be buggered. Hey, Lightwolf Hunter. Just trying out some levels made by viewers. I think this one needs a bit of beta testing. I'm the best at breaking games. If you need beta testing done, I'm the one that you should go to. Right. Let me restart and just have a quick look and see whether or not it will come back. This somehow reminds me of an E3 fail presentation since 86. Right, let's try again. Let's see if I can get it working. Maybe Drunk Dougie Boss has just passed out, Sestroya. You might have gone to sleep, yeah? Quite possibly. Right. We're restarting anyway. Do loading. Okay. I'll give it another go. Go in, press the button, and see if it works. If not, we'll join. Ooh! Roblox Raids joined as subscribed. High five to Roblox Raids for subscribing. And we've hit 21 likes, as Lightwolf Hunter. Awesome. If you are enjoying the video, do give it a thumbs up. I'll give it a thumbs up now. It's gone to 23 now. Thanks for giving it a thumbs up, peeps. Right. Kenneth's been murdered by the evil demon known as Ian the Butcher Higton. You must vanquish the butcher, but first you must defeat his minions. Oh no, it's Jonabob. Destroy him. Thanks to you, Jonabob. There we go. Good job on taking out Jonabob. Got a lot more ammo this time. He was a massive self-pleasurer. There's still many more demons. Something. Welcome to the hellish dungeon of Drunk Dougie. Ah, there we go. You have summoned Drunk Dougie, you fool. There we go. Aha! I destroyed Dougie pretty easily. Drunk Dougie the Keiko Demon. Perished. Prepare to enter the Down Underworld. Lots of ammo and a plasma rifle as well. Okay, here's the Down Underworld. Beware of the crazy demon, Iarena. Take this, Iarena. Still alive. Taking a lot of punishment. My word. There we go. Sorry, Aya. There we go. Ooh. Armor. The master of sin, Diana Kay. Here we go. Apologies. Murdering you. That was skin and bones, Deanna. There we go. Sorry, Deanna. Now which way? I'm gonna jump over here. Get the health. The secret health bit. It's kind of cool. Down Underworld. Very clever. Demon in the sack, Mr. Buttersauce. Lovely. Oh no! It's an invisible one of these fuckers. Ow! Oh shit. The demon in the sack has hit me in the knackers. Okay, Mr. Buttersauce is down. Demon in the sack. Very good, very good. Can't go around there. You put a lot of time and effort into this one, man. This is well good. Oh, secrets. Oh, shiny. What is this? A teapot? What does that even mean?
Teapot.
Teapot? Okay, awesome. Balls, my map shit compared to this, says Drunk Dougie. This is like Ian's greatest fantasy, a whole level dedicated to killing his fans, says John D. Also, you missed a secret in Drunk Dougie's room. Oh, can I go back? Where's the secret in Drunk Dougie's room? Let's see if I can find it. How do I get back in there? Teapot? No, I can't get back in there. Hello, Lizzie. She's walked in on Higton killing his regulars again, she says. Indeed you did. Indeed you did, ma'am. Okay. Apologies for missing the Drunk Dougie secret. Now where? Wait. Yeah, lots of ammo. Good job I checked behind. Prepare to enter the hopeless territory of Jumbo Jimbo. It's a health boy. Sounds like this could be a little bit meaner. Okay, here he is. Jumbo Jimbo. He's made himself a mancubus. Oh, I'm on fire. I think I'm... Oh, this has got ammo now. Take that, Jumbo Jumbo! This is what you got. Oh, fuck! I got killed by Jumbo Jumbo. Oh, he's still alive. Take this! This is what you get for making an excellent level! Blah! Teapot, it's a quirky object you can make with a single click in 3D Studio Max. So I'm going to guess that's a 3D software he used to make this, as Mark Rocks Nuts. Oh, here we go, here's the secret. Secret teapot?
Teapot.
Teapot. And a super shotgun. Alright, so I saw off Jumbo Jimbo pretty well. Some munitions, a heavy assault rifle. Oh, I'm gonna stick with the super shotgun. Guts to stick with the super shotgun. Okay, where now? This is where I came from, right? Yeah. So it must be on the other side. On through to the other side here. Here we go. This is amazing, man. Good work. Good work, JJ. Finally, Jumbo Jimbo has been silenced. He was an annoying ball bag. Lol. Warning, here lies Ian the Butcher Higton beyond this point. Right, let's waste no time. Where am I? I don't know how I feel about having to kill myself. But it must be done. Oh, secret area around here somewhere. Wait, what? Secret access around here somewhere. Super secret stash over here. Uh oh, fuck! Haste. Do I need to unlock the thing? Super secret stash over here. Super secret stash, give him hell. Nice. Ooh. Oh, that's a fucking rocket launcher. Probably should have waited to spawn the Ian demon. How do we do that, by the way? Oh, I wasted it. I wasted it! Seems to be a little bit funny about... Damn it, Ian's demon didn't spawn. I swear it's the snap map's fault, not mine, says Jumbo Jimbo. Ah, no way. That sucks. What time is it? Oh. I could try and run through again really quick. Should have spawned as you entered. I'll try running through it one more time quickly. Ooh. We'll try one more time. I'm just cursed at breaking games. It's my fault. What games did I break? I broke Serious Sam VR at E3. They said it's not broken before. This is the first time it's ever crashed on us. I was like, dude, I break all technology. All of it. What would what P32 level would be complete without a game breaking glitch, says John D. Well, exactly. Teehee. Oh well. We'll give it one more quick run through. And then try out Dougie's level. The truth is out there, Ian doesn't exist, says Still Life. It's true.
I was a figment of your imagination all along.
Alright. Charge! I will defeat them all! Starting with John of Up. Pulled his butt open and whipped him to death with it. Yoink. Yoink. He was a self-pleasurer. Time for Dougie. Oh, I guess it means I can find the secret in Dougie's one as well, I guess. There we go. Oh man! That Keiko demon just... got punished by my shotgun. Where would the secret be? Where would it be? Where would it be? I don't want to die. Oh god. I think I'm gonna give up. I'm gonna give up looking for it. I'll find you one day, secret. Alright. Australian time. To pick up the plasma rifle. Oh. That was Aya done. Now to take care of Deanna. Sorry, ladies. Oh, shit! Wow. Turns out Deanna's pretty rough. With the beatdowns. There we go. Sorry. Oh, I missed it. I missed the other button. Sorry, Jumbo. Some of the health from the secret area down here.
Teapot.
Deanna smacked him down, says Mark Rocksnuts. That was quite a slap. Alright. So we got full armor, full health. Make sure I got full ammo. Yeah, it looks like it. Jumbo time. Shoot him in the big bum. Oh god. Oh. Run away. Blop, blop, blop. Ow. Wow, he's a tough guy. Ah, oh, Jumbo got me as well again. Oh, look at my corpse. All mangled and weird. Ah, oh, there we go. Sorry, Jumbo. What the fuck? What happened there? I looked down in the comments. Thought I was instigating a... Holy shit. Jimbo's kicking my arse. Thought I was instigating a glory kill, and then I died. There we go. Woo! Alright, so are we gonna get to see the coolest boss in the game? Me. Let's find out. I gotta go before I see Ian commit murder suicide. Boo. Good work, Jumbo. Bye. This is still life. See you later, still life. Press that? No. Okay, here we go. He was an annoying ball bag. Spawn me, baby. There he is. It's Ian. Run away. I'm running away from myself. So what I want to do is activate the secret. That's not how I'm going to do it. Oh! Oh! Oh no! Ow! Oh. Where was the super shotgun? I did forget the super shotgun somewhere. Alright, so it's still alive. Fuck it. Okay. So, we're gonna grab the rocket launcher, the armors, the ammos, and I just gotta wait for this speed thing. Oh god, Ian is playing with himself, says Lizzie. Hey, I'm not Darkseid Phil. Oh shit! As if he could make his way over here. Oh! Sorry, me! Yeah! Killed him. Good and good. Now where are we going? This way? This way. Congratulations, you have taken down the legendary Ian the Butcher Higton. Yeah! Now you must escape before his angry chatroom mods come to get you. What? Oh my god. I've got to escape. How do I escape? I guess there must be some buttons to press somewhere. Maybe. Can't jump that, can I? Oh no! Ah, is this looking for something? Oh no! He's tricking me! What's this? Red power core. Green power core. Grey power core. Blue power core. I've got all the power cores of the rainbow. Guess it was a blue power core we needed. What's this? Boom! There we go. May Kent's soul now rest in peace. Ah. So I teleported over here after finding the power core. How do I end it? Beep boop. Victory, you win! Yeah! Incredible. That's an amazing level, man. That is absolutely incredible. That must have taken you days to make. Fair play. I'm honoured that you would spend so much time on a platform 32 themed level. Everyone who's got Doom, you should totally download this this one and give it a thumbs up. The code for it was GZQ776KM. So there we go. So that's the code if you want to have a go yourself. Definitely worth a thumbs up. That was very awesome. Right. I didn't think I was doing it. I was going to be able to manage a 2-hour stream and we've gone over that. But I need to play Dougies quickly. So, UMYD U. That's a G for a start. U M Y D. V S Q. V S Q. What? U M Y D V S Q. You've missed it. Oh, there we go. There was no F in the last one. U M Y D V F S Q. Okay. V F S Q. Here we go. P-32 crew. The P-32 crew have been turned into demons. This is a map with increasingly dangerous waves of demons. Can you survive until the end? Let's give it a go. Do do do. Okay. Start the game. Here we go. P-32 crew by Drunk Dougie. Wah, 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 wah. Now we've got to sit through a 10-minute loading screen. Whoa. Who loves loading screens? I love loading screens. Who loves loading screens? We all do. Do, 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 do. Also, I'm making another one, says Jumbo Jimbo. Why? You're making another one? Well, let me know when it's finished, dude. Let me know when it's finished. Hey, Final Salutes here. Hey, Final. Just about to play the Doom level that Drunk Dougie has made. Me. Mark Rock's nuts there. Speaking QA tester language. Progression blockers. Class A bugs. Alright, here we go. Starting match. Okay, so we're in a giant hall. And I can hear monsters beyond the door. Welcome to hell, P-32 crew.
Please proceed with caution.
Get out alive if you can. Okay, so we got a shotgun and a plasma rifle. There's increasingly difficult waves of enemies, according to Dougie. So far we're doing alright. Uh-oh. Ow, I just got blown up by that one. Are they all going to appear in this room, or is there a way forward? These enemies seem tougher than they do in the main game. Taking a lot of punishment.
Go.
Ah, bodies flying everywhere.
Let the bodies hit the floor. Let the bodies hit the floor.
And this one. Oh, there's a door. Opened. Alright, what have we got? Heavy assault rifle. Oh, could only hold two guns in the snap map, maybe. Alright, he's downed. Jonobob was making one of these as well. Oh no. I think I should have picked up the combat shotgun. I'm gonna dump this in instead of this shotgun. Oh no, what? Oh no! Where did I put my combat shotgun? It's vanished. I've lost it. I named every demon and it's not showing, says Dougie. Oh no, what? Looks like Snap Map's a little bit rickety. Oh. Let's load it up one more time. And we shall see. We'll give it one more go. And then I'm going to have to get my ass to the aspirins. Sounds like someone's playing tennis outside my house. Does take a long time to load these. Schniffles, just talk amongst yourselves for a little bit. This week, this month, a bit of sweet, kind of a bittersweet thing for me, this. This month, Eurogamer got more subscribers in a month than Platform 32 has done in the whole of its lifetime. So, you know, excellent that Eurogamer's kicking off and doing well, but also, holy shit.
Please proceed with caution.
It's taken me like six years to get to 23,000. Oh, no names. No names, I'm afraid, sir. Wonder why there's no names. Maybe there's some kind of weird glitch. I'm just good at breaking shit. That's my problem. Well, these are some pretty steep stairs. Things. Just seeing if there's a secret. P32 is still the best destroyer. P32 has the best community. It sure does, final. Holy shit. Looks like John D's got a new arch nemesis. Who's not Jonabob. Matt Rot's nuts. I'm tempted to, I'm wondering whether or not bad guys are not spawning. I'm presuming there should be some bad guys around about now. I think Snap Map's playing silly buggers. Why do I always break things? This is why I can't have nice things, because I always break stuff. Give it one more go, and then I really need to get off. I'm not JD's nemesis, we're lovely pals, says Jonabob. You want to see what he says behind your back? Jonabob. Mark Rot's nuts is a vicious anti-Welsh racist, Ian, says John D. That's balmy. I did a sheep joke. I'm poorly. I think there's a glitch with SnapMap. It's probably just me. I passed on my illness to SnapMap. That wasn't meant to sound rude, Deanna. She's put, I'll give it one more go and then I need to get off, in quotations. Like I was insinuating that I'd play it one more time and then go for a diddle. I'm not. Too poorly. Too poorly for diddles. Alright, welcome to LP32 crew. Please proceed with caution. Right. What? Did I get it? Let there be names. No names. Boosh. To the next ones. Oh my god, I just punched that guy's guts out. Yeah, looks promising. So are these guys supposed to have names floating over their heads then, are they? I wonder who these ones are meant to be. Oh, fuck. Imp. Oh, no. Evil Mammal and Rena won. With caution. Those ones were. And what are your thoughts on Thief, that utterly boring game from 2013, says Alex McGinn. I thought it was utterly boring. I never got around to completing it. It was a little bit boring. It's a little bit boring. Every one of these demons is Kareem-like boost. Holy shit. He's in like two streams, but everyone remembers him because he was such an anus. Oh god. Oh god. Oh god. Oh god. Oh god. Oh god. Shotty to the body. Oh, holy fuck.
Please proceed with caution.
A conduit was the big beast, was it? Oh, John D was the John Dee was the Hell Knight. Difficult. Circle Street boy. Oh god, who's that? This is falling down. Fuck! Fuck! You don't get health back from these guys. Oh, mashed.
Please proceed with caution.
Mine. Get out alive if you can. Conduit is that annoying Welsh kid, right? People say. You guys are so cruel. John Dee's head off. I think that was supposed to be Mike Tiger or Ed 2003. Oh god. Who's this one? Fall into the lava. Guess not now. Oh. Charge.
Please proceed with
mine. Definitely tougher in Snap Map. Oh, it was Plankton, was it? Coming for you, Plankton. Here, it's safe. It's not that safe. Sly ammo stash. Plankton does not want to go down. Oh, shit.
Please proceed with caution.
That was Jonobob, is it? Everyone makes Jonobob a pinky demon. I wonder why. Oh no, I forgot to pick up the armor at the start. Oh no! Secrets around here, allegedly. Ow. Ah, here we go. Shit. Screw John Bob. Whoops. You have to finish him off with one of these, do you? Let me see. It's like that, is it? Hold on. Oh no! Oh no! Whoa! This guy's too hard. It's designed to be caught, says Drunk Doggy. Oh, I see.
Please proceed with caution.
Mine. Final boss is Kent, says Mark Rocks. No, not Kent. Final boss is Pontiff Sullivan. No! Ow. Ow. Hello! There it is! Come on. Fuck! Oh man, right, I'm gonna have to run past everyone or something and get to the last boss. Cause I'm way past my ill bento. Off. He's going to bed as well. There we go. Got ya. Thank you. through these terrible twosome. Jump on these guys. Dead. Ah! Mine, mine, mine. Mine, 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 mine. Lots of health. Lots of ammo. Through here we go. That was John Howland Magoo that I just killed there, allegedly. Who the hell did I just... Whose leg did I just snap at? Oh my god! Christ. Oh, fuck. Alright, I died. Right, I'm gonna have to give it, I'm gonna have to give that a rest. But next stream, I will invite someone along to play co-op with me. If this one, I think Dougie says this one was meant to be. That was Ravenblade and Mark Rock's Nuts. It was meant to be played co-op. So next stream, I'll get Dougie in to play it with me, and maybe anyone else who's got Doom on the PS4 as well. But yeah, thank you very much, everybody. How do I? I don't know if I saved that map or not. I'll get it next time anyway. So yeah, thank you very much everybody for watching me stream some Doom, even though I'm a little bit poorly. Thanks, big thanks to Drunk Dougie and Jumbo Jimbo for making some awesome platform 32 levels. I'll do some more 1-4 players it is. So yeah, we'll try and get some more people playing it with me next time I do a Doom stream, Dougie. Thanks to 86 Mad Hatter, Drunk Dougie, John D, Alex Magoo, Final Salute, Ian's Bot. What the fuck is that? As you can see, this is not one of Ian's forte. The fuck is Ian's Bot? Thanks to Lizzie. Thanks to Mark Rocks Nuts, thanks to Jumbo Jimbo, Emma Harkman, Stroyer, I think I've said Lizzie, honestly, Mark Rocks Nuts, I've said, that's pretty, John Bob, that's pretty much everyone who's been chatting in their last 15 minutes, so thank you very much everybody, hopefully I'll be a little bit better when I stream something for you tomorrow. Not sure what yet. Maybe some Dark Souls. Bye!